So, hello everyone. Hi, am I visible and audible to you people? I am Dr. Priyanka Sachdev and I welcome you all for this session. I am your educator on an academy. So, today I am here to take a lecture on our oncology series. I have launched oncology series. In this oncology series, I am going to cover all tumors of the body one by one. I will cover benign as well as malignant tumors. So, today's session is on lung tumors. The most important and difficult topic to understand is lung tumors. Now, I will cover theory also, MCQs also. Theory will be helpful for cracking your university exams, especially in surgery, in pathology for the MBBS students, and also in theory, new MCQs can be framed. And I will cover MCQs also, which are already appeared in the past year exams, that is NEET PG, FMG and INICT. So I will cover both theory as well as MCQs. First, I will teach you theory about this topic. Then I will launch polls, MCQs in the form of the polls. So let's start it. Lung tumors. So lung tumors, we know that lung cancer is the most common cause of cancer related death, cancer related mortality in males also and in females also. Let me tell you the classification of lung cancer. We classify lung tumors in two ways, histological classification and clinical classification. Now I will tell you, first I will tell you the two types and then I will tell you reason why we are classifying it in two different ways. So let me talk about first histological types. Histologically, we divide lung cancers into five types and clinically we divide in two types. So let me start with histological classification. Histologically, we divide it into five types. So what are the five types? So these are the five types you can see. Just give me a second. So the five types you can see on the screen, it is squamous cell carcinoma, adenocarcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma number one, also known as epidermoid carcinoma, adenocarcinoma number two, number three small cell carcinoma, number four large cell carcinoma, and fifth one is the combined squamous and adeno. So squamous, adeno, small cell, large cell and combined small and large cell, combined tumors. So these are the five histological types. I will talk about them. Just listen. Let me tell you first clinical classification also. So let me write this classification first. From histological classification only, I will make out clinical classification. That's why it's necessary to write it once. So what is the histological classification? I have told you squamous cell carcinoma number one, adenocarcinoma number two. Adenocarcinoma itself is of four types. I will tell you the four types in detail. Then small cell carcinoma, then large cell carcinoma, and then combined squamous plus adeno. Combined adeno squamous carcinoma. From these five types, if I divide them clinically, these are the histological types. Clinically, if there are only two types, small cell carcinoma, in which I will take the small cell, and non-small cell carcinoma. So in non-small cell carcinoma, I will include squamous cell carcinoma, adenocarcinoma, large cell carcinoma and combined carcinoma. So all these carcinomas will go in non-small cell carcinoma. So clinically we'll divide in small cell carcinoma and non-small cell carcinoma known as NSCL. Have you got it? NSCL. So small cell carcinoma includes small cell carcinoma only. It is not SCC, means small cell carcinoma. And non-small cell carcinoma includes squamous cell carcinoma, adenocarcinoma, large cell carcinoma and combined squamous and adeno. I hope you got it. Combined. So these are the two. Now why? The question arises, why? Clinically we are dividing only in two types, that is small cell and non-small cell. Why we are not dividing in other types? Why? The answer to this why? Because the treatment of small cell and prognosis of small cell differs from rest of them. That's why it is necessary to separate and identify small cell carcinomas separately. So small cell carcinomas treatment varies. Prognosis is very poor. Their prognosis is very poor. They have worse prognosis from all five. And treatment, they are most radiosensitive and most chemosensitive. So they respond to radiotherapy and chemotherapy dramatically. Now the two statements are contradictory. On the one side, I am saying prognosis is very poor. It metastasizes very early. It reaches in stage 4 very early. Very early. So very fast metastasis is there. But they respond to chemo and radio dramatically as compared to others. So though both these statements are true for small cell carcinoma, that's why I'm separating small cell from rest all carcinomas known as non-small cell carcinomas. Small cell carcinomas constitute only 20%, rest approx 75 to 80% is non-small cell carcinoma, that is squamous cell carcinoma, adenocarcinoma and large carcinoma and combined also. So I hope you got it. I hope you got it. So that was the classification. Now name the mutations which takes place in lung, which leads to these cancers, which leads to these lung cancers. So there are two mutations mainly, EGFR and VEGF. Please learn it. EGFR mutation and VEGF overgrowth. So these two mutations lead to lung cancers. Done. Let me move further. Let me move to the gross and microscopy. So let me start with gross. In gross, there are two type of presentation. You can see a lung. Now, do you know this is the lung, this is the trachea, these are the two bronchi, right and left. You can see the two lungs, right and left lung in front of you, not tumor. Do you know what is this point known as? Just a second, let me change the color. Okay, what is this point? That point where bronchus is entering inside the lung, this point is known as hilum. This point is known as hilum. Now, if tumor is present here at the hilum, hilum is at the center. So these tumors are known as central tumors, central or hilar. Central tumors or hilar tumors, hilar tumors. Or else they can present at the periphery anywhere. So tumor can present anywhere. Just a second, what happened? Okay. Yeah. So tumor can present anywhere at the periphery. At the periphery, it can present here, 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 anywhere. So this presentation is known as peripheral. Peripheral presentation. So in short, there are two types of presentation. So you can see here in the diagram also, you can see the two type of presentation, hilar presentation and peripheral. Yes or no? So this is the hilar presentation. You can see here is the tumor and this is the peripheral presentation. So for all five type of tumors, squamous, adeno, small cell, large cell and combined, you have to say which type of presentation is present in which type of tumor. So I will tell you all. So hilar presentation, most common presentation, here tumor is present near the main bronchus at the point of entry of the main bronchus. Usually it is on the right side and it will occlude the lumen of the bronchus. Yes or no? It will occlude the lumen. No? So these tumors present early because patient will present with breathlessness. So here occlusion of the lumen takes place. And these ones, the second ones are present at the periphery. So no occlusion of the lumen takes place of the bronchus. So they will present late. So that is the thing. This is hilar type and this is peripheral type. Peripheral type will present as a consolidation at the periphery like pneumonia patch. So it is seen like a pneumonia patch and this one is seen like a nodule or ulceration. So that is the gross. Coming on microscopy and important features of each of them. Let me start one by one. So I will teach you all five. Let me start the first one, squamous cell carcinoma, also known as epidermoid carcinoma. So you can see this table. The fifth one combined you can leave. It is not really important. I will teach you the first four. Squamous. First I will teach you squamous. Then I will teach you adeno. Then I will teach you small cell. Then I will teach you large cell. So one by one we will take. So let's start with squamous cell carcinoma. See this table. This is the squamous cell carcinoma, the first one. So, okay, I will ask you six questions. You have to answer. Among these, your options are squamous cell carcinoma, adenocarcinoma, small cell carcinoma, and large cell carcinoma. You have four options A, B, C, D. From these, you have to answer six questions. Let me ask six questions. Which is the most common type in the world? World or overall? Overall, just a second. Okay. Overall. Which is most common type overall? Which is most common type in India? Which is most common type in males? Which is most common type in females? Which is most common type in smokers? Which is most common type in non-smokers? Who will answer me these six questions? Options are same. The four options ABCD are in front of you. So there are six MCQs which already appeared in your past paper, past exams. Very, very common, very important MCQs. So let me answer them. Most common type in the world is adeno, but in India it is squamous. In India it is squamous, squamous cell carcinoma, but in world it is adeno. Most common type in males, it is squamous, but in females it is adeno. In females it is adeno. Most common type in smokers, again, as far as smokers means squamous, but in non-smokers it is adeno. Please learn it. However you learn it, please learn it. So that was the summary. I tried my best, okay, to summarize it. So these are the six questions written in front of you. Okay. Okay, let me change the color. Let me use a highlighter. Okay. So can you see which is the most common type overall? Here it is written, the first two questions. So overall it is adeno. Most common type in India, it is squamous. Done. Most common type in non-smokers, it is adeno. Most common type in smokers, it is squamous. Most common type in females, it is adeno. Most common type in males, it is squama. So, 6 questions, 6 MCQs. Let me start one by one. I am starting with the first one, squamous cell carcinoma, also known as epidermoid carcinoma. As I have told, it is the most common type in India. I have already taught you. It is the most common type in smokers. I have already told you. Now, it occurs at the hilar region, central. It always occurs central. It never occurs peripheral. So, squamous cell carcinoma occurs centrally, hilar region. Again, important MCQ. Please learn it. Histologically, if I cut this tumor and make a slide of it, what I will see? I will see this picture. What is the main point in this picture? Please try to decode this picture. So, see this tumor cells. The arrangement is in the form of sheets. The tumor cells are arranged in the form of a sheet. In sheet, you can see individual tumor cells. These are the tumor cells. Now, you can see some pink colored material. Let me take a different color. Okay. Can you see this pink colored material? Acellular pink colored material outside the cell also, and the same pink colored material inside these cells also. What is this pink colored material? This pink colored material is keratin. So, keratinization is a feature of squamous cell carcinoma. Never forget. Not only here in lung, anywhere in the body, squamous cell carcinoma means keratinization. So, keratinization intracellular as well as extracellular. When it is present extracellular, it is in the form of a pearl. It is in the form of a pearl. It is known as ball or pearl. Pearl means moti. So it is known as squamous pearl. Yes, squamous pearl. So intracellular and extracellular keratinization is a feature of squamous cell carcinoma, the pink colored acellular material. Done. So that was about it. Now, what is the marker for this tumor? Just suppose I am a new histopathologist, I cannot identify it. So there are markers available in the market. These are liquid, brown colored liquid present in bottle. If I spread the liquid over the slide, this is a slide, over it. If it is squamous cell carcinoma, it will pick that marker. And if it is not a squamous cell carcinoma, it will not pick. So name of marker here is cytokeratin. So if I spread cytokeratin over it, if it is squamous cell carcinoma, it will pick it. If it is not a squamous cell carcinoma, it will not pick it. So that is cytokeratin. Learn the marker for squamous cell carcinoma. The answer is cytokeratin. Done. Coming on the next. So we are done with the first type, squamous. So it is present in smokers. Adeno is present in non-smokers. Squamous is more common in India. It is most common overall. It is common in males, squamous. And adeno is more common in females. Done. It is central. Squamous is central or hilar. Adeno is peripheral. Adeno is peripheral. Most common mutation which leads to squamous is P53. Most common mutation which leads to adeno is KRAS. KRAS. KRAS mutation. Please learn it. Most common feature here is keratinization. Here most common feature is glandular pattern. I will tell you. So let me move to the second type adeno. I'm starting with adeno. I hope you people are enjoying the lecture. Yes or no? So adeno, as I have told you, it is most common type overall. It is most common type in females. It is most common type in non-smokers. Tino cheese ulti ho gai. Tino cheese. So tino cheese ulti ho gai means what I am saying. So okay, let me use the pen. So most common type. Just a second, my pen. Okay, so most common type in males, most common type in smokers, and most common type in India. Answer is same. Answer is squamous cell carcinoma. Most common type in females, most common type in non-smokers, and most common type in the world, yeah, overall. Answer is same. Answer is adeno. So that is the summary. Yes or no? Yes or no? So let me use highlighter again. Okay, so it is peripheral. Squamous was central in location. It is peripheral. It is of four types. Squamous was only one type. Keratinization was a feature. It is of four types. So SNR, that is glandular, papillary, bronchoalveolar, very important, lapidic, and solid. Solid is also known as compact. I will show you diagram. So you have to learn four diagrams here. So first is SNR. Can you see? This is SNR pattern. So see the glands. Glands. It is glandular. SNR means glandular. Second is lapidic. Lapidic also known as bronchoalveolar. So here what is happening? Can you see? These are the alveoli. I am drawing here. These are the alveoli. These are the lung is made up of alveoli. This is alveolus of the lung. And these are the tumor cells. So here tumor cells will spread over the alveoli only. So tumor is spreading over the already existing alveoli. So such pattern is known as lapidic. So in lapidic, tumor is spreading over the alveoli. ट्यूमर इज स्प्रेडिंग ओवर द एल्वियोला नोन एज लैपेडिक पैटर्न. द थर्ड इज पैपिलरी. यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ पैपिलरी, फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शन. सो देयर आर मल्टीपल फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शन, पैपिलरी. एंड लास्ट इज कॉम्पैक्ट. कॉम्पैक्ट इज सॉलिड, एंटायरली सॉलिड. सो दीज आर द फोर पैटर्न. लुक, द फर्स्ट वन इज एसिनार, ग्लैंडुलर. सेकेंड इज पैपिलरी, फिंगर लाइक. थर्ड इज ब्रोंकियो एल्वियोलर. सो ट्यूमर सेल्स आर मूविंग ओवर द प्री एग्जिस्टिंग एल्वियोलाई. एंड फोर्थ वन, एंड द फोर्थ वन इज कॉम्पैक्ट. द थर्ड वन इज इंपॉर्टेंट, ब्रोंकियो एल्वियोलर. हियर स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ सेल्स अपीयर्स व्हिच आर नोन एज क्लेरा सेल्स. What are the markers for adeno? Markers for adeno, specific marker is TTF, TTF1 and CK7, keratin, cytokeratin. Cytokeratin is same for squamous and adeno. There also I have told you cytokeratin. CK here also cytokeratin, but TTF is separate for adeno. So this is TTF, you can see. So this is the glandular pattern. It is picked up only by adeno. So TTF hua yahan pe. Done. So we are done with squamous, we are done with adeno. Let's move to the third one, small cell carcinoma. Small cell carcinoma, the third one, also known as Oat cell carcinoma. So Oat cell is another name for small cell. Please learn it. So it is also associated with smoking like squamous. It is also central in position like squamous. So ye squamous ke jaisa hai. How, what is the diagram? This is a diagram. Now describe the diagram. Can you see the tumor cells? Yes, of course you can see the tumor cells. Okay, so tumor cells, describe each tumor cell. So tumor cells कैसे हैं यहाँ पे? These are the what happened? Okay, let me use different color. Okay, just a second. I'm sorry. Okay, so these are the tumor cells you can see. So tumor cells are small, like lymphocytes. They are blue with a blue nucleus. I can see only nucleus. I cannot see cell borders. So cell borders are indistinct. Tumor cells are small with small round circular blue nucleus. None. You can see the necrosis also. So necrosis is very prominent. Here it is not shown, but some of the cells are showing mitosis. So mitosis is also very prominent. So necrosis and mitosis. So cells are small with scanty cytoplasm, ill-defined borders, smaller cells, high mitosis, and with nucleoli, and necrosis is common. One more thing, if I zoom it out, I can't zoom it out here. If I zoom it out, I will see the nucleus. Let me draw a nucleus separately. So if I draw the nucleus, this is the nucleus, and you will see like dot inside that nucleus of this tumor cell. Now if you mix salt matlab namak, and pepper means kali mirch. So if you mix both of them, salt plus pepper, how it look? Light dark, white black. So it is looking like this. So the nucleus is giving a salt pepper arrangement. Very important MCQ. So can you see here? It is written here in my notes. It is salt pepper arrangement. So here it is written. It is salt and pepper arrangement. Please take this word, salt and pepper. It is seen in small cell. What is the marker? Marker is chromogranin and synaptophysin. Please learn the marker. So this is chromogranin and this one is synapto. So you have to learn the markers for each of them. And it is a tumor with worse prognosis, small cell. It is the worst prognosis. It metastasizes very quickly. Most commonly, it metastasizes to brain, followed by adrenal. Second most common is adrenal. And it shows paraneoplastic also. But it responds to chemo and radio dramatically. So we are done with the third type, that is small cell carcinoma. We are done with the third type, small cell carcinoma, Oat cell carcinoma. It is central in location, common in smokers. And here the most common mutation is BCL2. Now revise the mutation. Most common mutation in squamous is P53. Most common mutation in adeno is KRAS. Most common mutation in small cell is BCL2. Here, keratinization was a feature. Here, glandular pattern, SNR was most common. Although four types were there, but SNR was most common, so glandular pattern is there. Here, salt and pepper arrangement of the cells is a feature. Main point here is it has worse prognosis. It is most aggressive, but best response to chemo and radio. So you have to learn it. Coming on the last type, large cell carcinoma. Large cell. So large cell occurs peripherally. It occurs here. The tumor cells are large. They are large. That's why known as large cells. So it is not important. So last one is squamous adeno combination. So you can see keratinization also. It is squamous, and you can see glandular pattern also. So this is adeno. So you can see squamous and you can see adeno both in the same slide. So adeno and squamous in the same slide. So we are done with all. Let me tell you the important points among them. Squamous, adeno, small cell or Oat cell, large cell. Most common in India and worst prognosis to small cell ka hai. Best kiska hai? Best prognosis is squamous. best prognosis is squamous. So you have to learn it, you have to learn it. So overall we have learned small cell, and remaining all are included in non-small cell. So non-small cell contains squamous, it contains adeno, and it contains large. All three are included in non-small cell. Yes. So among these, the most common is adeno. In tino mein se most common adeno hai, because overall is most common adeno hi hai. Done. So response best to chemo is small cell, do not respond well to non-small cell. Done. So that is the thing. Let me tell you one. Yeah, 5-year survival. 5-year survival. So what, which is the best prognosis? So squamous cell carcinoma. So if 100 patients have squamous cell carcinoma, after 5 years, 50% of them will survive, 50% will die without treatment. And which is having worst prognosis? It is small cell carcinoma. So if 100 persons have small cell carcinoma lung, only 5 of them will survive after 5 years, rest 95 will die after 5 years without therapy. So it is having worst prognosis. Done. So that is the thing. Last thing here, which I would like to tell you, is paraneoplastic syndrome. What do you mean by paraneoplastic syndrome? Let me draw a diagram for you. Let me take the pen. Let me change the color. Okay. So can you see, this is a lung. Just suppose these are the two lungs. This is a blood vessel. This is a blood vessel here. Okay. So what is paraneoplastic syndrome? This is a blood vessel, just suppose, of the person. And this is the tumor, any tumor, any of the four tumors, squamous, adeno, small cell, large cell. So the tumor cells secrete some proteins in the blood. Those proteins will cause certain proteins or hormones in the blood. So those proteins or hormones will produce certain symptoms. It is known as paraneoplastic syndrome. So that is, paraneoplastic syndrome is common in lungs. So ADH is secreted, which will produce SIADH. ACTH will be secreted, which will produce Cushing syndrome. Parathormone will be secreted, which will also cause hypercalcemia. Parathormone causes absorption of the calcium. Calcitonin is also secreted, which will cause hypocalcemia. So hypercalcemia bhi hota hai, hypo bhi hota hai lung cancer mein. And gonadotropins are secreted, which will cause gynecomastia. Now the question arises, these are also secreted. Question arises, out of the four, squamous cell, adeno, small cell and large cell, which one is secreting which hormone? So you have to learn the list. So small cell is most important among them. Please learn, small cell is most important. Small cell carcinoma secrete ACTH causing Cushing and ADH causing SIADH. Small cell, squamous cell secrete parathormone, that's why it causes hypercalcemia. And large cell secrete gonadotropins, that's why it causes gynecomastia. And adeno secrete nothing. Adeno do not secrete anything. Please learn it. Very, very, very important. So same thing in front of you. Small cell, squamous cell, large cell and adeno. So large cell causes gynecomastia because of gonadotropins. Squamous causes hypercalcemia because of parathormone. Small cell causes SIADH because of ADH and Cushing because of ACTH. Done. So you have to learn it. Now some most commons. Then I will end this lecture. Listen, whatever is marked in this list, now see that only. So which is most common in India? Which is most common in world? Answer it. Most common in India, you know, squamous. Most common in world, adeno. Now, most common in young patients, in adeno. Young patients mein adeno hota hai. Old mein squamous hota hai. And most common to cavity bana dega lung mein. It is squamous. Again, two important MCQs. Most common to metastasize in the body. I have already told you it is small cell carcinoma. That's why it is having worse prognosis. So most common to metastasize in the body, especially in brain, it is squamous. But most common to metastasize in opposite lung, not in brain, in opposite lung. If it is on right lung, it is coming to the left side. And if it is on left side, coming to the right side, it is adeno. It is adeno. Now the two questions are different. Most common metastasize small cell karta hai. Lekin opposite lung mein most common adeno jata hai. So important questions. Most common clubbing kis mein hota hai? Clubbing of the fingers as a paraneoplastic syndrome. Again in small cell. Gynecomastia I have already told, in large cell. So you have to learn it. Now worst prognosis kiska hai? Best kiska hai? Who will tell me? So worst is small cell and best is squamous. So best is squamous. You have to learn. Most responsive to chemotherapy, most responsive to radio. Dono ka answer same hai. Small cell. So small cell, although having worst prognosis, but it is showing best response to the treatment, to radiotherapy also, to chemotherapy also. Dono ka answer small cell hai. Done. Most common site for metastasis, it is brain, followed by second most common site is adrenal, or you can say most common endocrine gland to be metastasized, it is adrenal. Coming to the next question, central kaun sa hota hai, peripheral kaun sa hota hai? Central means hilar. So central is squamous and small cell, these two are central, and peripheral is adeno. एडिनो एंड लार्ज सेल. लार्ज देर आर फोर ना, दीज आर पेरिफेरल. सो यू हैव टू लर्न विच ऑफ देम आर सेंट्रल, विच ऑफ देम आर पेरिफेरल. लास्ट थिंग पैरानियोप्लास्टिक सिंड्रोम. कुशिंग सिंड्रोम किस में होता है? स्मॉल सेल में. SIADH किस में होता है? स्मॉल सेल में. हाइपर कैल्सीमिया किस में होता है? स्क्वामस में, बिकॉज ऑफ पैराथार्मोन. थ्रोम्बोफ्लेबाइटिस एज अ पैरानियोप्लास्टिक सिंड्रोम किस में होता है? एडिनो में. एडिनो में आई हैव टोल्ड यू नथिंग ना, हार्मोन को सिक्रीट नहीं होता बट थ्रोम्बोफ्लेबाइटिस होता है. सो यू हैव टू लर्न. और यू ऑलरेडी नो मोस्ट कॉमन ओवरऑल एडिनो, मोस्ट कॉमन इंडिया स्क्वामस, मोस्ट कॉमन नॉन स्मोकर्स एडिनो, मोस्ट कॉमन स्मोकर्स स्क्वामस, मोस्ट कॉमन फीमेल एडिनो, मोस्ट कॉमन इन मेल्स स्क्वामस. So I am done with it. Now, if you want more such content, the lung tumors is not complete here. So if you want complete lecture on lung cancer, it is available free. It is available free, but on an academy app, not on YouTube. So on YouTube, that is a promo. And if you want complete series, not only on lung cancers, but all cancers from head to toe, in this way only, if you like the pattern of teaching, what you have to do, and there also on the app, you will find these questions, MCQs, in the form of polls. So most common type overall, most common type in non-smoker, most common type in India. So these are many, many questions from the past 5 years. Just 1 minute. So, just a second. Let me. Okay. So let me tell you where you will find the rest of the things. The rest of the things can be find to you on the Unacademy app. Yeah. So on Unacademy app, you can find it. So how to do access. So thank you very much for this lecture. Just go on the Play Store. From the Play Store, install Unacademy Learners app. If you install this app, you will find two options there. You will find two options there. One for free classes and one for paid classes. Free classes are known as special classes. So go for that option. You will find many special classes, free classes by me and other educators also. Complete oncology series is explained there and you will find all of them free there. And paid classes are also there for which different plans are available. After installing the app, search my name in the app, Dr. Priyanka Sachdev. See the spelling. You will find my profile link there. Just follow my profile link. You will get all my notifications and all classes together. So you can see the recording of any of the class and it's free. It's free. It is available free. So that is special classes. Why we are choosing special classes over YouTube? Why I'm not taking all the classes on YouTube and taking some on YouTube and many on special classes? Because special classes, you will find these features. The classes are interactive. You can interact with me. You can ask your doubts instantly in the form of chat and I can answer you instantly. I will launch polls and you will get the options ABCD. You have to click the option. I will announce the name of the winners. Who is the first? Who is second? Who is third? So you will get your real time ranking among the audience. So please just take the advantage of this live interactive class. You have an option of raise the hand like in classroom. You just raise the hand. I can see on my screen. If I allow you, you can send me a voice message. You can send me your question in the form of voice message. So you can do it. You will never miss a class because you always get notifications 10 minutes before the class. And you will get the notes there. PDF of all. Yahan pe notes dena mere liye possible nahi hai. But there I can give you. And you can see the class anywhere, anytime. But you should have a good internet connection in your phone. Done. These were the free classes, special classes. We have plus classes also, which are the paid one. So here we give structured courses. We give access for both live as well as recorded. India's topmost educators are available for teaching on the Plus platform. There are live tests, live quiz and much more. There is a question bank containing 25,000 questions, which are clinical based, image based, new pattern questions. So it is the best question bank available in the market nowadays. Done. And in Iconic subscription, there is one more paid subscription known as Iconic, along with Unacademy. Free live and recorded lectures. You will also get prep letter recorded lectures. So you will get the benefit of both Unacademy and prep letter. 4 batches have started on 11th of August, 2 days back on Unacademy. One is for FMG student, Focus FMG. One is for next student, targeting next, 2022. 1 and 2 batches are for NEET PG. NEET PG Ultra Rapid Fast Revision and NEET PG Test and Analysis. You can take the advantage of all these batches. Now listen, if you take the subscription now, you can access any of the batch. You can access FMG also, next also, NEET PG also. So in a particular batch, particular type of audience is targeted and we give our deliverables, our content in the form of what is important for FMG, what is important for next. So according to that, but you can access all. If you wish, you can attend all the classes. Done. And for one, there is a special offer going on. 1 month package for NEET PG. In NEET PG, only 1 month is remaining, right or not? Less than 1 month is remaining. So in the last time, what you have to study, what you don't have to study, there is a lots of confusion in your mind. So I advise you to take this package. The cost is only 4,500 only. It is very cost effective, most affordable plan. For 30 days, you will get ultra fast revision of all 19 subjects there. And you will get emergency room MCQs, clinical MCQs. Last 3 years papers will be solved by the educators with you. All the questions on the COVID will be given. Grand test series is there and much more. And you will also get 10% discount on this if you use my code. My code is Sachdev10. Please write it down. SACHDEV, my name, Dr. Priyanka Sachdev. Sachdev10 is the code. So if you use it, you will get 10% discount even on it. So 4,500 is the price. And there is a scholarship test tomorrow. You can participate in it on 14th August, 8 p.m. for 1 hour. 50 questions will be there and all of them will be numericals. So if you win, you are the topper, you will get 100% scholarship. Just a second. You will get 100% scholarship on the plus subscription. And if your rank is between 2 to 20, you will get discounts on the scholarship. So please participate in the scholarship test. And if you take a plan for 12 months now, you will get 2 months extra. And there are heavy offers going on plus. And Iconic 4-year subscription, that is the most affordable plan, cost effective plan. So if you are a first year, second year or pre-final year student, go for this plan. So it is 60,000 for plus and 75,000 for Iconic for all 4 years. And you can take convert it into installments also. So installment is nearly 1200 for this and nearly 1400 for this. So exact rates are available on the app. You can see it. And various other plans are also available starting from 2 months. Till 4 years. So whatever plan suits you, you can take that. There is one more feature on the app, ask a doubt. Whatever doubt you are having, take a snapshot of it and just post it under the specific subject. We will answer it to you. So the particular educator of that subject will answer your doubt instantly. So don't hesitate to ask your doubts. Whatever doubt you are having in your mind of any of the 19 subjects, just post to us. We will answer it to you. We are there to help you. We have a Telegram channel also known as Let's Crack NEET PG. So search it under Telegram and just join it. You will get notifications of all classes there. Please follow my profile link. Go on the app, install the app and search my name, Dr. Priyanka Sachdev. Follow my profile link. You will get notifications there. And remember, the code is Sachdev10. SACHDEV Sachdev10. Apply this code before plus or Iconic subscription. Whatever the payment is there, you will get heavy discount just before payment. So remember the code. You can also use this code for other purpose. If you are a new user, your friend is a new user, give this code to them. Distribute this code to your juniors, seniors, batchmates, everyone. And if they install an academy, they will require this code for unlocking the free classes, special classes, which I was talking about. So for free classes also, this code is useful. For paid classes also, this code is useful. You will get the discounts. Yes or no? So, okay. So that was all about it. Thank you. See you on the Unacademy platform special classes. Okay. See you. Bye-bye.